Hi everyone, Dennis Foley with Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about diffusion, and we all know from my past videos and my room designs that I'm big on quadratic. Quadratic is the only diffusion that I have found that satisfies all the five criteria for a real, true diffuse sound field. Now in a room, we know we have three real major sound fields. We have the horizontal, we have the vertical, and then we have front to back. So we really have three sound fields in a room that we must be conscious of. And we know from past videos that a one-dimensional diffusion, if we take a diffuser and we do it, probably, let's see if I got some room here. We position it vertically, we know that our distribution of the energy is in a horizontal array, okay? So if we take our diffuser and we put it horizontally, we know that then our diffusion is more in a vertical array. So the actual physical positioning of the diffuser determines the distribution of the energy. And we really need to think of a diffuser as a speaker. It's not something we plug in. It doesn't have a moving diaphragm to generate energy. But the energy that goes into it and then comes back out does act like a diffuser. So when we're after two dimensions of diffusion, we take both vertical and horizontal positioning, and that gives us two dimensions of diffusion. So it gives us a vertical and a horizontal array. Now, when do we use that? Because you see in a lot of our designs, you'll see just vertical diffusion. Some cases you'll see horizontal. So it just depends on what your objectives are in the room. What are you trying to accomplish? So here's the thing about diffusion. It's so distance dependent. So no matter what you're doing, a vertical or a horizontal distribution, no matter what you're doing with the diffuser, distance is the key. Why? Because the energy that goes into the diffuser and then comes out must have the appropriate distance to fully form and mature. So depending on the diffuser and sequence and the depth of the diffuser, certain distance requirements we have to have. So when we don't have enough distance for vertical or strictly horizontal one-dimensional diffusion, we can look to two dimensions. And the thing about two-dimensional diffusion, it'll work within distances that we cannot use for vertical and horizontal one-dimensional diffusion. So it all depends on what we're trying to do in the room, the usage, and the objectives of the room. So the thing about vertical and horizontal diffusion by itself, definition, separation, air, okay? When we're doing two-dimensional diffusion in a room, it's all about minimizing reflections and not localizing the distance. So we're trying with two dimensions to get the surface area to disappear. I call that psychoacoustic space. We're going to do a video on that coming up. So bottom line, if you have the room for vertical or horizontal diffusion and your objectives are definition and separation and air, then we're in good shape. If you don't have that distance, but still want the non-localization that you get with diffusion, we can look at two dimensions of diffusion. And I can determine that when you submit your room form. So I hope this helps clarify the diffusion issue that I see a lot. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to. So please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis. So that'll help you. Thank you.